Hey guys, welcome to Two Split. It's that time of the year when we tell you which games we thought were the best for us month on month for 2020. Make no mistake, these are our opinions, and there were some great games that released on each month we will mention. But regardless, these were our thoughts, and you might want to check them out, and we can have a conversation in the comments below. With that said, let's jump right in. We have January. January gave us Kentucky Route Zero. Now, this magical game has been 7 years in the making, and it's actually worth the wait. It's essentially a point-and-click adventure game with no puzzles, just choices that affect the progression of your story. But at the end, it sort of leaves you with something to think about. It's really deep. IGN gave this one an 8 out of 10. Moving on to February, the month of love. It was a weird one with a couple of weird games like Darksiders Genesis, Street Fighter V, Champion Edition. But the one that caught our attention was the one called Dreams. So Dreams is part video game and part 2 for making a video game. It's been described as a sandbox for video game. Yeah. Which lets you pretty much do whatever you want by designing your own experiences and sharing them with the world. Think of it as a creative social media network, unlike other social media networks. But this time it's a game that you're sharing for other people to try instead of a stupid meme of a cat or you twiddling your hair. You know what I mean. Moving on to March. March gave us Half-Life Alyx. Half-Life Alyx is a virtual reality title, and this is at the top of the pile.
I need a gun! Don't worry, it's unloaded. It's unloaded now!
Really good. You don't have to be a fan of the original Half-Life series to get into it, but it does bring a lot of some fan favorites, like the gravity gun, and, well, you do get gravity gloves in this case. But keep in mind that it's a prequel to Half-Life 2, so you may want to look that up if you really want to get into the lore, but it doesn't spoil the experience either way. It has great visuals, down to the dirty fingernails. I mean, it's so detailed, it's really nice. The main character, decent gunfights, and the diverse puzzle solving that keeps it interesting all the way. The game got a 9 out of 10 on GameSpot, and IGN gave this one a 10 out of 10. Also in that month, as an honorable mention, Nioh 2 was also released with his new counter system that influences the game and dares you to be more attack mode, if you will. And it's still quite challenging, so if you're not really into hard games, stay away from that one. Rolling on to April, that gave us Final Fantasy VII Remake, one we've been waiting for quite a while. This is nostalgia galore, if you know what I mean, because if you're familiar with the series, this is from way back 1997, and it was an awesome game, so fans were a bit skeptical when the remake was announced, considering it's a pure command-based mechanic. But somehow, Square Enix pulled it off, delivering a game that was not just cool for newcomers, but also appealed to longtime fans of the series, especially me. Graphics are fantastic, updated mechanics, Cloud Sword is still ridiculous. If you know the game, you know what I'm talking about. And we love it, we love it, we love it. IGN gave this one an 8 out of 10. Going up to May, the game that caught our attention was called Man Eater. Yeah, it's not a woman that goes to clubs to pick up guys. No, this one is literally a shark. Everyone loves Shark Week, and with this game, it can be Shark Week every day. You play a big angry shark eating people for revenge. Who knew eating everything in Psych 2 would be so much fun? You can get updates to your armor, special attacks. Yeah, I'm still talking about a shark in case you're wondering. It all comes together with a documentary style narration by Chris Parnell from Rick and Morty. So if you're a Rick and Morty fan, this voice will sound very familiar to you. Moving up to June, the controversial but fantastic Last of Us 2. This is the return of Jill and Ellie, sort of. Those of you who play the game know what I'm talking about. It has some social conversations to be had. This one stirred up, again, online, there were yays and nays, but all around, they all agree it was a fantastic game. It's a deep story, brutal combat, great mix of emotionally layered design. It is definitely not to be overlooked. If you can stomach the violence, I think you should check it out. Personally, I'm a bit torn with the direction they took Ellie in, but I still enjoy the game because you can play it any way you want it. You can either choose to be gung-ho or stealth, but all in all, they brought back fan favorites. The screamers, the works, everything is in there. It is totally worth checking out. IGN loved it so much, they gave it a 10 out of 10. And finally, jumping into July, we have one of my personal favorites, The Ghost of Tsushima. That's right, this one with the sword, Ghost of Tsushima. So it's a samurai game based on an invasion of the island of Tsushima by Mongols in 1274. Yes, it is based on a real event. The story sees our samurai Jin Sakai evolve from his way of the samurai to fight and free his home from the Mongol terror. This one borders a little around his ideals. And again, some social conversations to be had. I think some people in China had some problems with it, but hey, the game's a game. The game is essentially a samurai movie. Even with the black and white mode, you can play it in if you wanted to get that old school feel. It has a great story, excellent combat, tons of missions to keep you busy for a really long time. some of the best parts include the standoff mode. This lets you take down multiple enemies in a single strike. Of course, if you make a mistake, yeah, you're probably the one that's gonna die. But it's simply awesome. GameSpot gave it a 7, which I think it's really a bit unfair, but what do I know? IGN gave this one a 9, which sounds about right in my book. And that's it for where we are so far in 2020. Let us know if any game you think deserves to be on the list, and we can have a conversation in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe. I will see you in the next video. Take care, guys.